After you create a web app, you might want to associate a custom domain name with that web app so that you don't have to use the Azure Websites.net URL. You can use something that's more appropriate for whatever your app is. And you can actually purchase a custom domain right from within the Azure portal. So let's look at how you can do that. I'm going to go into my web app here. And in the menu, I'm going to go down to custom domains. And then I'm going to click on buy domain. So the first thing I need to do here is have a look at the domains that are recommended to me based off of the name of my app. Now my app is Jim's app. And these are all domains that are similar in name to my app. And all of them are available. I can easily purchase one just by checking the box here. And then I can go through the purchase process. So let's say, for example, that I wanted to get jamesapp.com. I could select that and then go through the purchase process. But let's say that the domain that I want isn't actually listed here. Let's say that I wanted really jimscoolsite.com. So I can just simply enter that, and then I'll click away from this box, which will then initiate a new search. And it will come back and tell me if that's available, and in fact it is. So I'm going to go ahead and just click on this to select that domain. That's the one I want. And now I need to enter my contact information. So I'll click right here, and then I fill out my contact information here, which I've done magically through video editing. And then I'll go ahead and click OK. That's going to validate that domain order, just make sure that all of my contact information is in the right format and everything like that. Now I can choose whether I want to automatically renew this domain. So if I do that, it will automatically renew the domain every year and charge that to my Azure account. I'm going to go ahead and leave that selected because I don't want to accidentally forget to renew and lose my domain. I can also choose privacy protection, which is enabled by default. Now this is something that normally you would pay for through most domain registrars, but if you purchase a domain through the Azure portal, you get that for free. And what that does is it hides that personal contact information that you filled out there when people look up your domain. I'll scroll down a little bit here and notice that it automatically will assign default host names to my domain if I leave these two checkboxes checked. So therefore, after I purchase this domain, I would then be able to browse to my site using the www subdomain and also the root domain for the domain that I'm purchasing. So I'll go ahead and leave those checked because that way I can avoid having to manually do that after the fact. And I'll go ahead and click OK. And now I can read through the customer service agreement. I can go ahead and make sure that everything is exactly the way I want it to be. And then I can click on buy right here to purchase that domain and have that added to my Azure subscription.